Welcome back to the video. Now, before we start, how sick is that lion? So basically today we are talking about RPE, which stands for rate of perceived exertion. So we're going to talk about the benefits and the disadvantages of RPE and how to properly use it. So in a nutshell, RPE stands for rate of perceived exertion, and it is a scale that goes from 1 till 10. So 1 meaning it's the absolute easiest thing you can do, and 10 is your absolute limit, you cannot do no more. So in terms of powerlifting and strength athletes, I generally like to use it in terms of reps in reserve. For example, if you're an RP of 7, that means you'll have 3 more reps in the tank. RP of 8, 2 more reps in the tank. RP of 10, you're at your max. And vice, and it just goes down and up using that method. So some of the advantages of RPE is that it helps you to auto-regulate your workouts. So as we know, with percentage-based workouts, you'll do your reps based on a percentage of your one rep max. And life happens. There are always, you know, external factors that can influence how you're feeling on the day of. So let's say you had your, you know, all your working sets based off of a one RM squat of 400 pounds, but you had a really long work day, you didn't get a lot of sleep. So, you know, your projected one rep max will probably not be that as high on that date. And so trying to do reps at that projected one rep max might be too taxing on your system, might cause you to overshoot. And so this can actually ruin your peak in the long run and, you know, inhibit your performances on competition day or when you're trying to hit your one rep max. So the nice thing with auto-regulation using RPE is you can gauge how you're feeling that day and drop your intensity a little bit so that you're still working at the right intensity so that you don't overshoot or push your body out to ruin your peak. Now, one of the disadvantages of RPE is it can be harder for some people to gauge, especially newer lifters. So that's when you can use a combination of RPE and percentage. So you can give your lifters a target using percentage, but then also give them the option to auto-regulate using RPE. So if they're feeling really hot, they can go a bit higher, increase that intensity, or if they need to, lower it to make sure they aren't overtaxing their system. So I personally like to use RPE, and I'll use RPE for a lot of my athletes, or I'll use a mix of both. I think it is really great to teach people how to auto-regulate using RPE. Percentages are also great. It just depends on the person. Some athletes prefer percentage, some athletes prefer RPE. You can use both to get the best of both worlds. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I also have lots of new KF merch. Links will be in the description. Support the channel, support me. Cop your swag and look good as you work out in the gym. My next video, I'll be giving you guys a full recap of my performance at the IPF World Championships 2021. So I'll be breaking down each lift and telling you guys what happened. So if you haven't already, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe so you don't miss any more content. Thanks for watching, guys. Train hard, train smart, see results, get CAFIT, and we will catch you next time.